What's going on, YouTube? So today I have two treats for y'all. Number one is this Fleeky 5x5 lace closure wig install. The second one is a crazy story time of me in high school. My badass. So, before we get into the install, y'all already know I gotta announce my $100 giveaway. This is a special giveaway I'm doing once a month. All you have to do is be subscribed to my channel, like this video, comment below, and leave your Cash App. Have a chance to win $100 and all the products from this video. What is going on, guys? It's your girl, Easy Breezy, and I'm back with another hair sponsor. Thank you so much, Asteria Hair. Now, I've worked with this company in the past, so I'm glad that they're back on my channel. And they sent me a 22-inch, 180 density, straight lace closure wig. And this is a 5x5 lace closure wig, by the way. So it's gonna be nice and wide so we can give it those frontal vibes. Now, y'all know I love installing frontals because they're just fun, but I'm not gonna lie, I really like doing lace closure wigs too. Number one, because they're so quick and easy, and number two, because they're quick and easy. And you can also make it look like a frontal, kinda, and give it those frontal vibes without like the ear to ear action. So she might not be able to put it behind her ear. It may look kind of weird, but listen, she can still look fleeky and natural. And if she wants, she can still put it in a ponytail, but of course it has to be a low ponytail. But the benefits of lace closure wigs is, number one, you can apply it glueless. You don't have to use glue unless you want it to be, you know, extra secure, but it doesn't require glue. Number two, you can make it a middle part, side part, you can put braids in it. You can really, you know what I'm saying, be creative with it if you choose to. And one more thing, as you can see, with the glueless thing, I didn't put glue on this at all, and it still looks flat, it still looks amazing, but according to my model, she said that she would prefer to take it on and off at night because, you know, she don't want to sleep with it on, so that's perfectly fine. So now I must introduce my model to you guys. Her name is Mandela, and she's so beautiful. So she actually went to my same high school. I went to Shiloh High School in Gwinnett County in Georgia. And yeah, so we go like way back, right? So she kind of just reminded me of high school. So I can think of a few crazy story times from that time in my life. So if y'all watched my other video when I talked about when I got caught in my parents' bed, right? So this is kind of like a continuation for that story. So long story short, to sum up the last video, I mentioned that me and my high school lover at the time, we ended up, you know, doing the do in my parents' bed while my parents were supposed to be on vacation. So my parents told me that they were coming back on Friday, but they really came back on Tuesday. Perfect. That right there is a perfect example of parents being trifling. So long story short, right, my parents came home early and caught me and this dude in their bed, okay? It was the most embarrassing, uncomfortable, scariest moment of my life. Okay, my dad was just so shocked and disappointed, he didn't know what to do, but my mom went off. Like, she was yelling at me, she was calling me a hoe, she was like going in, right? So from that like moment, my parents told me that I could not go out at all that summer. And mind you, that happened the very first week we got out of school, so my summer just started. So me being the rebellious Aquarius that I am, you know, when they told me I was going to be on quote unquote punishment, I'm like, yeah, anyways, I'm like, I'm just going to wait this out for like 2 weeks, you know, maybe a week, they'll be over it. And I'm just going to be sneaking out the house anyway. Yeah, no. I thought it was going to be so easy for me to start living my life again. But for some reason, my parents, they really took this punishment serious. So one time, right, I went to my homegirl's house, snuck out, didn't ask them, because if I asked them, obviously they would have said no. So I went to my homegirl's house and we was chilling or whatever. And then all of a sudden, my friend's mom was like, "Hey, your dad is outside." And I'm like, "Huh?" So I look outside my friend's window and I see him. And my heart, y'all, starts racing because I'm like, I'm about to get whooped. So at this point, I'm already knowing, get out the house. So I walk out the house to the front door, right? And my dad jumps out the car with a belt and charges at me. And what do? Run. But listen, at this age, I'm young, I'm fast as hell, I'm running track at school too. So I outrun his ass. He could not catch me. I end up running through the woods and running to like this plaza parking lot and crying and calling the cops because I thought I was gonna die. I did not want to go home with him, period, point blank. I would have rather slept outside than go with him. So I think the cops took me home that night. I can't even remember, but yeah. So another time, right? So this is probably like a week later. Now, mind you, this is summer break for me, so I already can't stay still, okay? I'm wanting to go out with my friends. I want to go to house parties. Like, one day drives me insane, so let alone a week. A week? So my parents are out, right? And I use this time to sneak out again because, listen, I can't take it. I'm about to go crazy in this bitch. So we end up going to a house party, right? Me, my homegirl Finesse, and like a couple of our other friends. So we're out all night, you know, drinking probably Four Locos or something, whatever we was drinking at this time. So by the end of the night, Finesse's mom came and picked us up from the party. So when we were in high school, right, like one of our parents used to drive us somewhere and we used to all chip in and give them gas money. Like that was our like routine. And just so we don't make one parent tired of us, we used to like alternate parents, right? So I guess this night, you know, Jaleesa's mom was taking us to the party, picking us up, whatever she was doing. So this night after she picked us up, we were all supposed to go back to Jaleesa's house, right? So we're driving and I'm not really paying attention to where we're going because, you know, we're in the backseat joking around, playing, talking, whatever. So we end up pulling into the Walmart parking lot. So, you know, I think nothing of it. I'm just like, okay, I guess, you know, Miss Millie is going inside Walmart because she needs something, whatever. Y'all, we park and all of a sudden I see my mom's car pull up right beside us. And I look at Miss Millie and I'm like, this bitch set me up, bro. I couldn't believe that shit. I was like, I just got set up in this motherfucker just now. So Miss Millie turns around and she's like, well, your mama's here. And I literally can't believe it. I'm like, oh my God, I cannot believe what just happened. And I don't say nothing to her because, you know, I'm not finna disrespect my friend's mom or nothing. So I'm just like accepting my fate. Like, wow. I'm finna walk out this car and walk my way to an ass whooping. Haha, that's crazy. So, as I expected, I got in the car. She didn't say nothing to me. We went back to the house and I got whooped. And y'all, if y'all are wondering how old I am at this point, yeah, I'm in high school, okay? I'm a full high schooler at this point. I'm like 17 years old, still getting whooped. Crazy, right? So the next day, I'm in my bed and I cannot believe I have to stay in this house. Like, I am going crazy. I'm crying every day. I'm like, can I please go out? I hate my life. Do y'all remember when y'all used to get so mad? Y'all used to say, I hate my life, so your parents can feel bad. Yeah, My parents literally did not care. So in conclusion, I ended up staying in the house that entire summer. I didn't think it was possible. I didn't think my parents were actually gonna go through with it the entire summer, but they did. Yep, they sure did. So if y'all have any stories of y'all in high school, you know, getting in trouble, getting in fights with y'all little badass, let me know in the comments and let's talk about it. So back to this hairstyle. So we ended up doing some really cute layers on both sides, and now I'm taking my flat iron and giving it a little bump so it can have some shape and some movement. And I've been seeing these layers floating around like social media lately, and mind you, this style is not new at all, but it's coming back. You know how styles come back around every so years. All right, y'all, this is the final result of our glueless 5x5 lace closure wig install. And mind you, this wig was so thick. Mind you, this is a 180% density wig, so it's nice and full, it's heavy, got some weight on it, okay? So once again, thank you so much, Asteria Hair, for sponsoring this video. If you guys want this exact unit, I'm gonna put all the information in the description below. If you're not subscribed to my channel already, make sure you go ahead and do that and turn on your notifications. See y'all later.